Okay, so to finish up AVL rotations, what I'd like to do is just trace through some code for single rotations and execute a double rotation by calling each of these two pieces of code. So I've written an actual part of a tree right here. You can see I intend for 5 not to be the root of the tree, although you can imagine it is. And what I want here is for 5 to be at my out of balance node. And so I have and I've got the situation where my out of balance criterion tells me that I need to do a double rotation. So this will be right here. This will be the first edge that I need to rotate around. So I'll need to call a single rotation on this right here. So I'll need to rotate that way, push the 10 down. So that'll be a clockwise rotation around the 10. So if I'm doing a clockwise rotation, this is the code that I'll need to call to do this. So this will be my node N2 right here. And K points to N2's left. So here will be K as a reference to N2's left. And it says N2's left is assigned to be the value K's right. Here's what K's right points to. So N2's left will now point here. That'll be my new N2's left. And my K's right now needs to have the same value as N2. So here's K's right here. This needs to be having the same value as N2, so it needs to point right there. And then I return K. So this K is what's returned right here, which means when I return, what I have is that my 5 now points to the same thing that K points to, which is my 7 node. My 7 node's right child points to the 10. That's what I did right here. The 10's right child points to the D. The 10's left child points to the C. 7's left child points to the B. And 5's left child points to the A. And there's that portion of the tree that I've just adjusted where I've done my rotate with my grandchild and child. Now, of course, I'm not done. I need to do the rotate around the node itself that's out of balance and its new child. So that's this edge right here that I need to do my rotation around right here. So I need to do a rotation where I am pulling up on the 7 and pushing down on the 5. So we can see that's a counterclockwise rotation. So this is the code that I will be executing right here. Okay, so my N2 is a reference to that node right there because it's the parent of the edge that I need to rotate around. So K has the same value as N2's right. Here's N2's right. So here will be my K. N2's right is now assigned the value to K's left. Here's N2's right is now assigned to be the same value as K's left right there. K's left is now assigned to be N2. So here's my K's left right here. Points to the same place N2 points to. And I need to return my K. So that's what I return. So when I look at my final tree here that I've got my K is what's being returned right there. So I got K. K's right child is the 10. Right child doesn't change. Left child of 10 doesn't change. 7's left child now points to the 5. 5's right child now points to the B. 5's left child points to the A. And I'm done.